Hey there, viewers! The last year has been a trying one for all of us, but the good news is that there's light at the end of the tunnel. Vaccines are on the way, people. More and more seem to be getting approved, but there still are rightful concerns that need to be discussed. Today, we're talking 9 questions that remain even after vaccines are approved. Before we begin, keep in mind we're constantly seeing new developments, so info may change between the time this is recorded and the time it's put out. How effective will vaccines be? When will the general public be eligible? Is it healthy for pregnant people? We're talking all that and more. Number 1. When can pregnant women get vaccinated? We're starting off with a pretty urgent question, one that many soon-to-be parents are asking. The first vaccine trials conducted by companies didn't include people who were pregnant. This is usually because doctors are scared that it might harm the pregnancy. Well, if you're expecting, you'll be happy to know that as of February, vaccine studies on pregnant people are coming. Experts have stated that at this time, there is no reason to be concerned with the health of pregnant women when it comes to the vaccine. While there is no current data to show its safety on pregnant women, many experts are hopeful. This is because the vaccines in question are shown not to interrupt the human body's normal cellular process or alter DNA. Are you currently with child? Has all of this news about COVID vaccine been really making you anxious? Sound off in the comment section and start a conversation with our bestie community. Number 2. What if you're planning to get pregnant? Over the last year, so many couples have had to discuss whether this is the right time to have children. If you're one of these people, the COVID vaccine has likely come up in conversation. Unfortunately, there's no actual data to confirm whether or not you should wait to take the vaccine before you get pregnant, so people can't exactly recommend it or warn against it. But there is this to consider. During the second and third phases of clinical trials, several people were able to get pregnant, even after taking a sample of the vaccine. Keep in mind that they are still being observed to make sure there's no side effects. At the same time, the UK is advising its citizens to avoid pregnancy within the first 3 months of their vaccination. So, as of right now, things are still a little conflicted. If you're planning to have children within the coming year, I would listen carefully to what health officials in your country are saying. Number 3. Is it safe for people breastfeeding? For those of you who are already parents, this one is important. If you're a new mom who has taken the vaccine, is it okay to breastfeed your baby? Well, unfortunately, data on this subject is still pretty minimal. The effects of the vaccine on breastfeeding mothers hasn't really been studied. It doesn't seem to be unethical at this time. In the United States, someone breastfeeding may choose to be vaccinated. This is if they're part of groups that are already eligible. This includes people like healthcare workers. As for babies, things are also looking up. Vaccines by Pfizer and Moderna are said not to pose any sort of risk to a breastfed baby. Keep in mind, this is also something that needs more research. Number 4. How many vaccine injections do you need? To answer you plain and simple, you require 2 injections. I think the common belief is that you need just 1. This is for the best possible protection. After your second injection, you're considered fully vaccinated. As for the length of time between the first and second shot, well, it all depends on the vaccine. For Pfizer, it's recommended you get your second shot roughly 3 weeks after your first. If you've taken the Moderna vaccine, your second injection should come roughly 1 month after the first. In some cases, the second dose is given out 6 weeks after the first. I wouldn't worry too much about this, just as long as you don't get it earlier than recommended. Number 5. Do things go back to normal after the second injection? Well, the answer is kind of complicated. Not quite just yet. While the vaccine does give you greater odds, they're not 100% effective. Getting the vaccine doesn't mean that you're allowed to go outside and do whatever you want. It's not that simple. In order for society to have a chance at getting back to normal, the majority of people need to be vaccinated first. Do you know the phrase herd immunity? This is when a population of people are indirectly protected against a disease through vaccination or a developed immunity. As of right now, the amount of people who need to be vaccinated in order to reach herd immunity is unknown. It actually varies among different diseases. For measles, herd immunity requires around 95% of people to be vaccinated. For polio, around 80%. The remaining people who haven't received shots are protected by the fact that measles won't spread among those who've been vaccinated. Now, this doesn't mean that you won't be able to see your loved ones. The best thing you can do is practice caution, socially distance, and wear your mask until further notice. It all depends on when lockdown measures are lifted in your jurisdiction. Right now, all we have to do is wait for people to get vaccinated and see how things develop. Before we continue, are you looking to get in shape? Well, the liquids you're drinking can make all the difference. Check out our recent video on 17 unhealthy drinks you should avoid, according to experts. Now back to our vaccine questions. if I've tested positive, should I still get vaccinated? Currently, health officials are indeed suggesting that people who have had the virus should still get the vaccine. While you're slightly more immune to the virus than others, testing positive doesn't give you full protection. There have been reports of people getting infected for a second time. One woman in the Netherlands tested positive for COVID in April, only to feel similar symptoms again in July. After undergoing a test on a whim, doctors called her to say that she had tested positive yet again. While this is pretty weird, keep in mind that it really is a freak occurrence and doesn't happen often. By getting a vaccine, you are reducing your chances of repeat infection. You're also reducing the odds of spreading the disease to people who are much more vulnerable. Number 7, will we have to get vaccinated every year? This is another common question that people around the world are asking. Is this a one-and-done situation, or will we have to receive annual COVID vaccines? Well, as of right now, it's unknown just how long people will be immune to COVID, even after being fully vaccinated. People who have been vaccinated are still being monitored, so there isn't any data to show how long immunity lasts. There are also new strains of COVID that we have to consider. In December of 2020, a new variant of coronavirus was discovered. This can also cause COVID-19 symptoms. Since then, other variants have also been detected. Because of these developments, more research is required. For now, I would focus on receiving the first vaccination. Number 8. How effective will the vaccine be on the general population? It really all depends on just how long immunity lasts for. Right now, the data shows that the COVID-19 vaccine will provide you strong protection against the virus. But even with that, there's still a chance that you can get it after the vaccination. According to evidence given by the providers, the Pfizer vaccine is said to be about 95% effective. After getting vaccinated, it may take several weeks to a couple of months for the effects to start kicking in. Over time, your body is supposed to start building immunity. This means if someone has recently been vaccinated and comes into contact with a person who's tested positive, they can still get the virus. This will usually take place right after you've been vaccinated. Either that or you came in contact with an infected person just before your injection. Number 9. When will the general public be eligible? Current projections show that people under the age of 65 are generally ineligible for the vaccine. That is, if they don't have medical conditions that put them at higher risk. In the United States, reports claim that the vaccine will be available to drugstores as early as springtime. Other countries are reporting spring or summer. When and where we're going to be vaccinated are questions so many of us are asking ourselves. But in the meantime, you have to keep your health in check. Let's keep the conversation going with a couple more health videos, shall we? Check out our video on 12 super vegetables you should eat that pack some serious power. Or how about 12 ways you're cooking your veggies wrong? Go ahead, click one, or better yet, watch both, and learn more about how to stay healthy during the pandemic. Have you been vaccinated? Let us know in the comments below.